Use Euler's formula to write the following expressions in the form of a plus ib. So note that the Euler's formula is given by e to the power of it, which can be written as cosine of t plus I sine of t. And also the variant of this formula will be when you have a minus in the power, like minus it, which is equal to cosine of t minus I sine of t. Okay, so the first two examples are relatively easy because we're dealing with e's already. The last example is a little bit more challenging, but I'm going to get to it. So let's start with the first one. Realize that you can write this as e, because that's a constant, to the first power, multiplied by e to the power of 2i, right? That should be clear to you. And then you will basically see that it's e, the constant, right, multiplying e to the 2i. And now you're ready to use the formula. As you can see, there's no minus there, so we can use the original Euler's formula here, which will give us, so remember that cosine will multiply the e, so we should write e cosine of t. Not cosine of t. So t here is substituted with the real valued function of 2, right? So we have to evaluate the cosine of 2, right? So it's going to be e cosine of 2, right? Plus I, right? Because I is part of the formula, right? There's an I in the power. I sine of 2, and that's it, right? You have successfully written the first example in terms of, in the form of a plus ib. The second example, again, is straightforward. Actually, it's even easier than this, right? Because you don't have to actually separate the power, okay? So getting rid of the plus, basically, you don't have to do that here. It's already basically prepared for you, and you can use the formula straight away, right? So you're going to use the first formula, obviously, because there's no minus. So pi here, pi takes the place of the t here, right? So it's going to be cosine of pi, right? Because this is the real valued function at pi instead of the t, right? T is a variable, but pi is a real value, right? So pi is an input of t. Pi replaces the t, right? So cosine of pi plus I sine of pi, right? Which is equal to, now cosine of pi is negative 1, right? So I can just write negative 1 plus I sine of pi is 0, right? So negative 1 plus 0 is negative 1. There you go. That's your value. Now, as I said before, the last example is more challenging. You have to rewrite this so that your base is the e instead of the 2. Right, so first you're going to realize that you can write this as 2 to the power of 1 times 2 to the power of negative I, right? And then you know that you can write this further as 2 multiplying 2 to the negative 1 to the I power, right? Because the power of power means that the power is multiplying, so the negative 1 will multiply the I. Right, so now you can write this as 2 multiplying by 1 half to the I power, right? And then now you can transform this so that you have e present, right? So you know that I will write this as a note here. For example, e ln x is equal to x, right? So in order to have, imagine that 1 half to the I power is your x. So you need to have e to the ln of the 1 half to the I, right? So it's going to be 2 e ln 1 half to the I power, right? So that makes sense. So now you can use the properties of logarithms. You know that 2 e, the I will go down and will multiply the ln of 1 half, right? These are the properties of logarithms. The power goes down. Right? So when you're having the ln of something raised to that power, the power will go down. And you will just have the ln of whatever was raised to the power. Right? So it's going to be e to the I ln of 1 half. Right? So the I came down here. So now, one more ln property that we're going to use. You're going to say e to the I ln of 1 minus ln of 2. Right? Because we know that ln of a fraction means you will have ln of the numerator minus ln of the denominator. Right? So now you know that you will have 2e to the I. Ln of 1 is 0. Bingo. So you're left with negative ln 2, right? So it's going to be negative ln 2. But still, it doesn't look plausible enough, right? So we should write it in the simplest way. 2ei, well, let me withhold the I for a second. You can bring the minus in front of the negative I, right? So that we can use this part here, right? E to the negative I, right? So it's going to be 2e to the negative I ln 2. Bingo. Now you're ready. You're ready to use the second, the slight modification of the Euler's formula, right? So now you're going to have, and don't forget there's a 2 multiplying, so you will have 2 cosine of ln 2. And then now the minus plays a role because you have it in minus. Minus, and again, don't forget the 2, 2i, of course, part of the formula, sine of ln 2. Bingo. You have successfully written the given expressions using the Euler's formula in the form of a plus ib. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video.